Elections in India, huge expenses via banners, other publishing and media of registered political parties and controversy each other. Elections in India are known for the enormous costs caused through different means, including the utilization of pennants and different types of media by enrolled ideological groups. These costs have turned into a subject of debate among parties, as they will generally blame each other for overspending and neglecting the standards of fair rivalry and correspondence in the majority rule process. One of the significant wellsprings of costs during races in India is the utilization of standards and hoardings. Ideological groups frequently put a lot of cash in these limited time materials to contact an immense voting demographic. These standards are put across urban communities, towns, and towns, showing the party's image, the upcomer's face, and the party's plan. They are accustomed to drawing in the consideration of general society and to making a visual effect that would resound with citizens. In any case, the printing, establishment, and upkeep of these standards come at an impressive expense, which is frequently borne by the ideological groups or their backers. Besides, media stages assume an essential part in political races in India. Parties use TV, papers, radio, and the web to disperse their message and contact a more extensive crowd. Political commercials, meetings, and discussions overwhelm these news sources during the political race season. Each party endeavors to get however much broadcast appointment or space in these stages as could reasonably be expected to guarantee their messages are heard and resound with the electorate. These endeavors require significant monetary ventures, frequently prompting extreme costs. Notwithstanding, the consumption on standards and media distributing by enlisted ideological groups has led to a disputable discussion. Restricting gatherings frequently point fingers at one another, asserting overspending or procuring reserves illegally to fund their missions. This discussion originates from the conviction that the assets utilized for crusading ought to be controlled and restricted to guarantee that all gatherings have an equivalent opportunity to contend in the decisions. At the point when one party is spending essentially beyond what its rivals, it can make an unreasonable benefit and slant the majority rule process. The Election Commission of India is answerable for observing and controlling political election costs. They put down a boundary on consumption for each competitor and expect gatherings to reveal their wellsprings of subsidizing. Nonetheless, upholding these guidelines can be testing, especially with respect to consumption on pennants and media distributing. The Political Decision Commission depends on objections and public examination to recognize infringement, and it tends to be a troublesome undertaking to find examples of overspending or illegal financing. To relieve the issue of inordinate costs and contention encompassing races, there is a requirement for more grounded implementation and guideline. The Political Decision Commission ought to improve its observing systems and proactively screen the wellsprings of financing and costs brought about by ideological groups. Moreover, there ought to be an exhaustive public mindfulness crusade featuring the significance of fair contest and the pertinence of sticking as far as possible. This would assist with making a more level battleground for parties and guarantee that the vote-based process isn't undermined by unreasonable spending. All in all, elections in India are portrayed by tremendous costs, especially using flags and media distributing by ideological groups. These costs have prompted debate among parties, with allegations of overspending and out-of-line rivalry. To resolve this issue, more grounded guideline and authorization are expected to guarantee that all gatherings have an equivalent opportunity and that assets are gained and spent straightforwardly. At last, a fair and adjusted majority rule process is fundamental for the advancement and improvement of India.